Hi guys, welcome back. Had a couple of days off. We're back at it today. 1-2 in the last round, which was great for us and our intention of winning the championship this year. So, see how we can get on in Canada this week. Do enjoy Canada. Nice and fast.
Carl probably mentioned the new parts that are coming from the factory. Well, I'm not sure if it's good to know. I hope they've been trained.
But also, it requires you to be quite precise because of the walls. So, see how we get on.
To get through as many corner gates as quickly and precisely as possible. Best of luck out there. Zone is coming up. Get ready to open it. Distance is on your MFD.
I think last time we raced here, it was a wet dry race, which made things awkward. I think it was when we were going through our phase of really dodgy parts coming out the factory. Hopefully, we can have a bit of a smoother time this time. Got the last DRS thing.
Stuff. You've pretty much nailed this circuit. This is a really strong.
Get a bit more in frame now.
I know it's tempting to focus entirely on the race, but we should put a bit of time aside to run the qualifying sim program. Try to run it before the end of FP3 if you can. So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 13.6.
We'll probably be aiming at about the 111s, I would guess. Maybe the 110.
This test is all about tyre management. Try to control the slip through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex.
Got much better through that chicane than I remember it being last year. It was a pig to get the entrance and exit. I would have thrown it through that chicane, so much, much nicer. last year's start. Deep through the hairpin, but get away with that. That is weird. Oh, it just gave out on me. And it's gone back to it. Edit. Weird.
Program
I think that does continual problem.
We're top of the speed trap, 207.6 miles per hour.
That's nice too, Viv.
Testing fuel management here, so try to lift and coast going into the corners. Don't be too aggressive on the power, but remember, you still have to beat the minimum lap time.
Being fast through the speed trap is very important here. Bit of inside curve there, but I got away with it. Save a great deal of fuel there, but
okay.
Enough. Sometimes we're really on it. So you remember at Baku we were having issues with the system glitching and we've dropped everything down a high. Yeah, that has an effect.
This is all about managing your battery efficiently throughout the lap to hit your target.
If you run it back, 85% right now, 75. It's definitely using the GPU less than it was. A bit early, but crap ton of oversteer there. We were like over revving and then we under rev. Thank you. still getting that glitch.
Program complete.
Worry. Keep an eye on that.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:11.0. Give us some consistent laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into the race strategy.
A little nibble on the wall of champions there. Talk about attacking the curbs as much as you can through there and trying to straighten the corner. Very easy to hit the sausages. Much of the inside curve through there as possible. Hit the front lap as early as possible coming out of that chicane. A little bit deep off the hairpin, but not too bad. It's obviously a fast setup because we really make all our time up just on this back straight.
Great lap. You've nailed what we asked for. Keep it up.
Yeah, we're definitely not fast through sector 2. We barely keep up with our race pace through there. But then once we hit this hairpin, we're a little deep on again. Our pickup speed off it is great. 2/10 are 3, 4, yeah, we're just much, much faster in a straight line. Right, overtaking fun, but we're going to try and get the lead and
stay focused.
Hold it. Three and a half temps down through there, and then we make 3 temps back on that chicane, like on the start of this fast bit. And just the run up from here. Well, by the time we cross the line, we're a second up. I suddenly look very dark. Rain's predicted next practice, guys. Get this out of the way.
Okay, this is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat.
This traffic doesn't interfere with us. Time there. Looks like it's going to have to get redone because we had to go around the outside of the Renault. Complete. This is some 1 million miles away from. You know what? I'm not gonna bother. Only 25 points. Plus that fastest sector one, we weren't held up through that bit. 50-50.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Thomas, Leclerc and Kimi Raikkonen. What an incredible...
Lando was off pace.
That was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours. Do you have any comments about this team? You scraped the walls a few times. Were you struggling for grip? Great. Well, that's everything.
You got to ask me that question. Extra points. Sometimes it does, sometimes it's nice to simulate it will do the points that you might get on your one session. And it's just going to be cloudy. That always suggests that we're going to get some rain at some point. Mercedes in. Be the best start for that, but Lotus there as well, and we've got a Ferrari come out in our team bit better. Maybe we ought to get a bit of tow down the straights. Purple sector one, but not sector two. I guess it's all about Mercedes. Little twitch. Tip in the wall of champions. As planted as it did when we were just practicing. That's odd, I made all my time in sector one. There's your third, that's good. Alternate strategy, see where that plays us out. Yellow mark tires apparently go for 20 laps. I think this is about a 36 lap race. We may be at a one stop with just a soft set of tires. Ah, come on. Trying to avoid the situation we had in Baku where everyone was allowed to choose hard apart from apparently us, then we had to work our way back through the field. So I was able to sneak out a soft medium stint there. Oh, it gave me the pace to win the race. Gentle entry and then ending way too early. I Bit of a clobber there. Wing. Where that lies.
Car repairs have set us back a little.
Endo's fastest now. About four tenths temp. Pretty close actually. So it's me and Valtteri on the yellows. Ladies matching us with the split strategy. Yeah, this game seems to give a huge advantage if you can get on the yellows for your first stint, because it pulls you away from the midfield. You come in before then you normally end up work your way back through traffic. Turn one, but up and that cut it. Deep there. Gonna slow down too much, get it back in. Bit too much of the curbs on the first apex. AI not helping either.
Oh. You've just put in the fastest.
108, take that. We pull. Why did I suddenly make way more time in the final sector? That was a little tidier through the hairpin, but it didn't feel that bad. With qualifying, Lando's, he was way off the pace through his first stint.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. It's always good to qualify at the front, isn't it? Are you happy with where you'll be on the grid tomorrow? Great. Well, that's everything.
Parts department's happy. You know, because they'll cry and not put in as much work. We don't nice them. I get why they put it in. It just doesn't. Feel natural. It was video gaming.
All right.
I know we're playing a video game, but
we should be in with a good chance in the race. Before we begin,
now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
Why is that slower? Didn't have enough for practice, so I can't. Hunter will spin off the line. Should be down a third.
Okay, the start was fine. Let's try and move forward.
I'll stay with Lando. Nibble at me. It's had an issue. Quite happy for a lap. Well, these guys are much faster off the corner than me. Want to start bringing that gap down to Hamilton.
Is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Not neat whatsoever. That was close look. DRS. So much faster with punish hang. Should be able to get him. If I don't overdo it. should be able to get him, I was going to say, into the, if not the final hairpin. Why is it? I had it baited too straight. All the beans. It's gonna have to be into the first corner.
Nice work, that brings you up a place.
Gives us feedback. Now we can control the race. The only other thing I've really got to cover is one stoppers. One Bottas who's... I can't even see. Oh, he's miles down. He's 10th for 11th. Gearbox issue. And, any of these soft guys are going to try and run, go onto the hards, then I'll just switch onto a one stop, could easily cover them. Yeah, Lando's sort of.
We're leading our teammate by 3.1 seconds.
He's on that pace being really good. Even at Baku, he's not particularly fast mid-session. Four seconds off the back of us. We're just going to use our track position over Hamilton. Matches of defense against us. I think we're about to head to.
Use your overtake button.
I think we're going to head to the crossover soon. We haven't already. Pulling out that little bit on him, getting out of DRS zone. And those in like a nice little pocket on his own. 3 seconds over the Renault and the McLaren. Another 3 seconds back. 3 seconds off Hamilton as well. Be a little careful, I feel like I've been thrashing the gearbox a bit. Stop. Shifting so hard. Now that I've got that buffer.
strategy is available on the MFD. Confirmed.
No. Interesting early stops here. There's Bowdry on his mediums. Yeah, the stops are giving up already, they're not one stopping.
The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap.
Like he stayed on soft. Definite two-stop strategy for them. Push for the next 5 laps. Build as best I can over Bottas and Raikkonen. Hamilton's showing that pit isn't very long. He was 3 seconds behind us, he's only 17 now. Basically, right next to Bottas. Lewis being stuck behind Kimi's. Good for us. Well, good for our team. And they went onto the mediums. Lewis has got. Really done with him holding up for a couple of laps. Thank you.
Lewis is definitely faster than us at the moment.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs.
I've seen already. The soft. I guess would be he's doing what our team's suggesting we do, which is the medium, soft, medium. I think we'll be fine going medium, soft, soft. Gotta make the softs last about 10 laps. Bando's now stuck behind Kimmy. Kept it nice and close off the hairpin, so hopefully. Between us and Lewis.
Gap to teammate behind is 22.3 seconds.
Just watching Lando and Kimmy bounce between each other. I think Lando had made a move and then backed out of it. He's ahead again. He's now 9 seconds down on Hamilton. I think I'm in a two-horse race. Lewis is approaching the final chicane now.
Go, go now. Okay, stay
clear. Passing us on track, but we're going to have that shortcut through turn one. Cross over into the track. Clear. That's caught us a bit, but they're like a DRS, so much older tyres now. Mm-hmm. I have two attempts at pass that, one now and one after our next pit stop. I would predict our next one to be better, but it's always worth having a bank cut. That gap back up.
That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
Bit deep through turn one. Put them all back together. It's about loading up on fuel. In the event of another safety car in the next seven laps, we'll have to go to mediums again. That's why they don't want us to pay you. Probably only got back from that.
We're leading our teammate by 14.7 seconds.
Ricardo's keeping him honest. Renault's starting to really work. Aaron. Got Ferrari, Bottas behind them. Even if Lando can't overcome Hamilton, it should be another good net point gain for us. Bottas way out the order.
Overtake and burn some of this energy.
Hamilton's having a box already. Those softs have gone away from him. Got five laps on ours. Comfortable from here. Hamilton's now stuck behind his teammate.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed.
Right from back.
Are you all right? Engine off, engine off.
Way too much curb on entry. Second one you can use curb. First one you've got to be more gentle with.
Is 24.4 seconds. They're on old mediums. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:13.7.
What's awesome?
First position, front of the pack. Lando is behind you. The gap to the car behind is 18.1 seconds. They're on old mediums. Pit window will open in 3 laps time. Pit window opens in 3 laps. 14 laps to go.
That's the answer I was looking for anyway. How much has appeared? Medium.
Fuel target is +1. Faster engine modes are available.
I've got fine.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs. Is coming in for a stop.
He's not double soft in it, he'll... He's going off. Why go on the hard? This game makes really weird decisions sometimes. Got about 6 seconds on Ricardo now, and Ricardo's got Magnus in front of him.
Yellow flag, it looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car. Some information on Vettel.
Message. Good year for Ferrari, much like in real life. Not really on the pace. I just don't get the strategy of this game. Why did Lando go soft, medium, hard? Honestly telling me he's used up that many tyres.
We're boxing this lap. Give us the best in lap you can.
Probably make it on the end on these tyres, actually. Pit stop window anyway. Spare. Which again makes me question why they think going on mediums is better. In other words, can't be that close on the crossover.
Go, go, go.
1.9. Nice.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
What the fuck was that? Bit lazy on my steering. Just didn't want to pull it away from the wall. Got my fast lap ambitions. Why we put the banker in? Out the throttle there. Yeah, it's going to be a bit nice, eh? He is. No fuel, plus the DRS help. Sketchy. Not making this a pass to that. That's gonna do it either. Mm-hmm.
able to run in this engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix two soon.
Yeah, that's it. Give us some room. Just in PG saving mode, engine saving. Aim for the wall, net, and I just got wasn't paying attention, being a bit lazy. Plan is for season 3 to remove flashbacks. Play this game properly. But mistakes like that, nervous.
You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap.
The rate would go. We're gonna run out of engine.
There's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
By the look of it, the engines only want to last 6 rounds. They need to last 7.
One lap of extra fuel. Fuel target plus one.
Thank you. something, I think. That was very nice on tyres. That's why it annoys me when they do stuff like they have done to Lando. He's now looking like he's under a little bit of pressure from Ricardo. Because he's on the hard. Should be okay. And traffic doesn't want to get them too much close because they'll go in a DRS zone. 1.2.
There's 4 laps of fuel remaining.
Mercedes at the hands of Hamilton, still fast. Oh god. They've got a bit of work to do to bring that gap down.
This is your final lap of the race.
Lando's just got to survive one more straight, I think. Pretty well holding that gap. 1.2, 1.3 still. Keeping him in. At DRS. Another win in the books. It looks like another double podium.
It wasn't always plain sailing today, but a very important win nonetheless.
Yeah, our start's better, but apart from that, these lanes stayed in.
Set them apart from the competition today.
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Thomas increases their championship lead. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Well, for me, it's got to be Lewis Hamilton. The multiple world champion may be the boring choice at this point, but you can't argue that he's a driver deserving of his reputation.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. It was a tough race for our championship leaders who lose ground at the top of the table. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
11 points gained on that one. No, more than that, 21 points, I think, gained on that one. Lando's moving his way up the table. Back to our 50-point gain that we had before.
before Monaco.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that.
Your team must be ecstatic with how you're performing.
How do you feel seeing your teammate up on the podium? That was an epic battle today. How do you think this will play out?
Modest.
Appreciate your time.
As before, not spending any cash right now because we wanna.
Morning, boss. This week's income from the sponsors has cleared, and we're making good profit against our running costs.
Make sure that we pay for Lando, race or two. I'm feeling good about our durability right now. Invitational. Right next. Fresh. When the actual events make sense that you're doing. For example, we're going to Paul Ricard. I have an invitation to Paul Ricard. DG speed dial. Gold. Remember rightly, this is the 97 version, so the one that Villeneuve took to the title. Last world title Williams had. Bad news that they left the team. The best. I'm pushing, but I don't really get near him. Thank you.
That was where I was making a mistake. I'm just not making it scream as much as I should. Really, what I need is low fuel as well. Why am I catching them? Do anything wrong? We're in here. France now.
I recommend we could go for something like this.
Why not? Thank you.
would be the next go for the Ink Cooler. Any upgrade to that upgrade? I'll get specs for you. Yeah, we want to maximize kind of the spec twos by the end of this season. Play it by ear. If there's a tech rate comes in, then we'll. And failures. I'm screwing this. Yeah. Seven was Monaco. You gotta make it a Belgium on this engine, really. Because, yeah, they make the last one last till Italy through to Abu Dhabi. Bit of a problem. Benny had it. We put it in Monaco. Oh well, that's for next time. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll be back next time for France. Have a good one, and I'll see you guys later. Bye now.